the crystal ball of fatherhood's future, shattered into millions of pieces at my feet, there are serrated surfaces slicing my soft skin as I collapse to the floor, desperately trying to glue them back together again. I wanted to set myself on fire, boldly burning in a brilliant silence, praying that my masculine exterior would melt into wax roses, and the defiant phoenix of my womanhood would be made visible to you. But to you, wax roses smell like brimstone and eternal damnation. My only father in this entire damnation made me wash the lipstick from my mouth as though there were filthy words smeared across my face, my manicures only lasting for a day before having to expunge them from my cuticles. It was hard for you to distinguish my beauty from wickedness, and I wanted to set myself on fire to give you what you expected, a burning demon who cannot meet your expectations, suffocated in blue boxes, waiting for my body to shift and become more truthful. You called my hormones mutilation. I called them liberation, life-saving medication. My breasts in oversized t-shirts, telling my sisters I pierce my ears because that's what rappers do, stuffing my dresses into garbage bags, burying my truths for you. You told me you felt sick to your stomach on the first day that I felt beautiful, and I wanted to set myself on fire to adopt a scorched earth policy, burning through any trace of my inadequacy, placing myself in the crucible, every unacceptable ore of my gender, purified to your standards. But my metal is made of the mica of shimmering makeup, and somehow a full face of Maybelline is easier to breathe in than the masculine masquerade that is coming to an end. I would rather be an orphan daughter than a silent son. I am dangerous and beautiful, and you will never stomp me out.